ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب زدني علما. رب زدني علما. اللهم فقهنا في الدين. اللهم فقهنا في الدين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to benefit the most from this series that we are beginning today, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the time that we spend here beneficial for us and make it heavy on our scale of good deeds on the day of judgment. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, sisters. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. We are in the month of Ramadan, and we can only make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us in this month, and we are able to maximize our ibadah, we are able to maximize our dua, and we benefit from the blessings of this month, inshallah. Ameen. Sisters, today we are beginning a series that is going to be basically four short sessions during this month of Ramadan. And the title of this series, as you can see on the screen, is Strengthening the Heart. Now, I have a "the" over there, strengthening the heart, but it's actually strengthening my heart. And for you, sisters, it is strengthening your heart. And why do we talk about strengthening our heart? We will address that in a minute. But first, I want to just let you know that there are going to be four sessions once a week, inshallah. Short sessions, not very long. So inshallah, it's not going to take up a lot of your time. You can just log in and listen. And in the first session today, I'm going to introduce you to the series. And inshallah, I'm going to talk to you about the challenges that we have in strengthening the heart. And in the second session, inshallah, we are going to go ahead and talk about the protection of our heart and how do we protect our hearts. And then in the third session, inshallah, we are going to talk about nourishment of the heart. So what is the food for the heart? And then in the fourth session, the final session, inshallah, we are going to talk about istiqama, so stability of the heart. How do I ensure that my heart remains stable, inshallah? So let us begin. Why talk about the heart at a time like this, especially in Ramadan? Why talk about the heart, and what does the heart really mean? As Muslims, we have to understand that the heart is an organ that is not just the physical organ. The heart has a lot of other things as well that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us several times in the Quran, that the heart can listen, the heart can feel, the heart understands, the heart is diseased, the heart can be closed off, the heart can become deaf, dumb and mute as well. So all of these things, the heart is not just the physical heart, but I'm talking about the spiritual heart. And why is this heart important? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, Allah tells us, he tells the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to tell everyone else that whoever is an enemy of Jibreel alayhi salam should know that he, what? Nazzalahu ala qalbika bi'idhnillah. Should know that he has revealed this Quran to the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This Quran was not revealed to the aql of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It wasn't just revealed to his tongue. It wasn't just revealed to any other, his hands or his eyes. It was revealed to his heart. This Quran came down to the heart of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another place in the Quran, in Surah Shura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again tells us that this Quran is a revelation from the Rabbil Alameen. And it has been brought down by who? By Ruh al-Amin. Ruh al-Amin is Jibreel alayhi salam. The Ruh that is al-Amin is truthful. Is completely truthful. And where has it gone? Where has it been brought down? He carried it down where? To ala qalbika. To upon the heart. Your heart. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being told, this Quran was brought down into your heart so that litakuna minal munzirin, so that you can become one of the warners. So this heart has the capability of receiving hidayah, of receiving guidance. So now the question is, that is my heart capable of receiving this guidance. Because if this Quran was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's heart, then we have to also understand that my heart and your heart, sisters, are also capable of receiving hidayah, of guidance, of receiving this Quran. And in this month of Ramadan, which is the month of the Quran, is my heart open? Is my heart ready to receive the Quran? So when I hear the ayat of the Quran being recited, do they penetrate through my qalb? Do they penetrate through my heart? Or do they just go through my ear and that's it? And I don't really feel them. I don't connect with them. I don't receive the Quran in my heart as I'm supposed to. And this is why this series is titled Strengthening the Heart. Because only when I strengthen my heart will I be able to receive the Quran. Will I be able to understand the value of the Quran? But if I don't open my heart, if my heart is not strong enough, if my heart is not clean enough, then do I really think that revelation is going to come into my heart? That it is going to move my heart when I hear the ayah of the Quran? Is this revelation that is so beautiful, will I be able to let it sink into my heart and change my behavior and change my lifestyle and change me so that I can become more connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That is the question, right? This heart of mine is not just a physical organ. I understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given this heart of mine a lot of capabilities, and those capabilities include many things. And one of them is the ability to absorb the ayat of the Quran, and that will help me change my behavior. And many scholars have spoken about this, but let's simplify it, inshallah, for our purposes in this series and in this Ramadan. How can I simplify this? Well, one of the way to simplify is that if my heart is a vessel, if my heart is a vessel, then the natural state of my heart is that it inclines towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the natural state of my heart. That is my natural fitrah, that I will always incline towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is it that obstructs the heart from recognizing this potential of inclining towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What is the one thing that is going to obstruct it? Sins. My sins, minor, major, whatever. Sins. All kinds of sins. These sins actually obstruct my heart from recognizing its natural potential, natural inclination. It's going to stop it. So I need to ensure that this vessel, this heart of mine, is clean. And how do I do that? I do that through tazkiyah, through cleaning it. For example, if you have a bottle of water and you put really clean water inside the bottle, and you let the water stay in there and it's clean, but the bottle is dirty. There are impurities on the rim of the bottle. When you pour out water from that bottle, the water which was pure will automatically become impure because of the impurities at the top of the vessel of the bottle. Or if there are impurities on the sides of the bottle, even if they're outside, but you can't see the clear water inside, right? And eventually those impurities that are outside on the vessel and on the rim of the bottle will penetrate inside and corrupt the water that is inside as well. Now let's take this analogy and compare it to my heart. If my heart is a vessel, what if I don't keep cleaning it, if I don't keep scrubbing it, if I don't clean the lid of it, the rim of it, and I don't take care that those impurities that keep accumulating because of my daily sins, if I don't keep cleaning it, what is going to happen? Then what is inside my heart will become corrupted as well. And do you think the Quran can be in a vessel that is impure? Do you think the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can ever go there? It cannot. It cannot. What is impure cannot accept the Quran. So if I want to benefit the most from the Quran in this month of Ramadan, then I need to ensure that my heart is strong enough to accept it, that my heart is clear enough to accept it. Now, this seems like a Herculean task because it is so difficult to make sure that your heart is ready for the Quran. But for the purposes of this series, inshallah, and you know, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us time and you know, an opportunity, then inshallah we will do a more detailed series about the you know, the tazkiyah of the heart. But for the purposes of this series, what are some of the challenges that are very clearly there and that we can at least take care of in this month? At least we can make those baby steps, right? Because today's session is about challenges, correct? So we are going to focus on the challenges. And according to one of our scholars, very well-known scholars, Imam Ibn al-Qayyum, he said that the five things, the five despoilers of the heart, the five things that corrupt the heart, and he gives us a list of the five things. And so today, let's talk about those five things. The first, he says, is the company of worldly people. So the company that we keep, the company that surrounds me, the people whom I hang out with, the people who are constantly around me, are they more involved with the world? Are they so engaged in the dunya that they don't even think about the akhirah? They don't even think about the end of the world? They don't even think about what's going to happen to them when they go into the grave? They don't think about any of those things? Is my suhbah of those people? Because if it is, then my heart is being affected. And I have to be very selfish when it comes to my heart. I have to change my company. I have to change my suhbah. Because if these people are constantly around me, are constantly talking about, you know, subhanAllah, TV shows or sales in these, you know, brand name clothes or other things, you know, anything involved with the dunya or parties or da'wats that you have to go to, or, you know, or this person has this thing and that person has that car and that person has that house. If I'm constantly surrounded by people who are constantly talking about the dunya, then my suhbah is incorrect. Then I have to fix that. That is something I need to work on, right? Because that is affecting, negatively impacting my heart. The second point, following our desires, following the nafs, whatever I want, I want. It's not a question of need anymore. If I want this, I want this. I'm so obsessed with my needs and my wants. And my, you know, desires are basically the shahwat, right? The desires that we have, that I want to have the latest clothes. I want to have the latest phone. I want to have latest everything. I'm so involved in running after my worldly desires that I forget that my heart needs time to breathe. It needs time to think about the akhirah. My heart needs time to rest, get away from the dunya. Because, you know, what did Hassan al-Basri say? That, you know, he said that hold the dunya in your hand, not in your heart. And that's how we're supposed to use the dunya. We're not supposed to put it into our heart and let it sit there and take over and corrupt everything else. So following my shahwat, following my desires, going so obsessively compulsive about things that I want. And then the third, love for something or someone other than Allah. When the love of something or someone takes precedence over my love of my Creator, then yes, my heart is going to get corrupted. Yes, my heart is going to get corrupted. It's a natural thing that's going to happen because the heart is made to incline towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but I have put in so much of information and so much of dunya into my heart that my heart is now inclining towards somebody else. And that is what a diseased heart is. And the Quran talks about it several places. You know, the heart that has a disease in it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our hearts from being diseased. But this is essentially what it is. And then excessive eating and excessive sleeping. Points number 4 and 5. Excessive eating. Because, you know, we know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that the son of Adam can, feels nothing worse than his own stomach. So, you know, overeating, excessive sleeping. Subhanallah, sisters, we are in the month of Ramadan. Are we going to be excessively eating that so I'm so tired that even praying Isha becomes a difficulty? Am I going to sleep so much because I'm fasting and I'm so sleepy? I'm so sleepy. You know, the excessive sleep, what it does is that it takes you away from what is the most precious commodity that we have, which is time. So sleep. Use sleep as something that rejuvenates you. Use sleep as something that makes me feel fresh when I wake up. But excessive sleeping, and we know this, that excessive sleeping never makes us feel good. Excessive sleeping always, always, always makes us even more tired, even more sluggish. And so does excessive eating. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us to ensure that my heart is pure, I need to make sure that I eat to feed my stomach and not to feed my heart. And I sleep enough to refresh my brain and my heart and not to make my heart and my brain sluggish. These are the five basic things that we can work on this Ramadan. And sisters, I am making the commitment. Inshallah, you make the commitment as well. And we will work on this. And inshallah, you know, this will help us. These are the challenges. This is what today's session is about. These are the challenges that we face when it comes to corruption of the heart. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from our hearts being corrupted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to allow our hearts to grow, to breathe, and to turn towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the natural inclination. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow my heart and your heart to be free of all corruptions, all despoilers, and everything that stops it from turning towards, you know, towards Allah, towards the Creator. And we can free itself from the traps of the dunya. Ameen ya Rabbul Alameen. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an hudan lin-nasi wa bayyinatin من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.